This is the ultrasound study of a pregnant female primary gravida. For her very first ultrasound of pregnancy, sent to rule out any uterine adnexal or fetal anomaly. Cephalic presentation, as this is the head of the fetus, this is the body of the fetus. I wish to get some better view to get the bifacial diameter. This is a stage of the gestational age. The fetus is really quite active. So at times you get the BPD by just placing the probe, and at times you have to spend some time getting to the proper . This is the face of the fetus. This is the facial fetus. This is the eye. These two white echogenic areas, now this is the cranium, this is the fox cerebra, and these two echogenic areas that you are seeing is the are the choroid plexus. Choroid plexus are seen. The cranium is well developed. And here we are seeing the facial features along with the. This is an ideal age, gestational age, to get the nuclear transferency. And here we, this is the nuclear transferency. This area, we may get the nuclear transferency. It measures 1.9 millimeters and it's within normal range. Given sometimes time by brighter diameter, so why not to see other features of the pregnancy. Now you see this is the leg and foot. This is the femur, tibia. Now, what does the femur length correspond to? 14 weeks gestational age. And this is the knee joint. This is the tibia. And this is the foot. This is the foot. This is the abdomen now with cardiac flicker. See at this location. this is the cardiac trigger, this area. This is the abdomen. This is the transverse of the abdomen. This is the umbilical cord. Transducer 90 degree angle, avoiding the kidneys and the heart in the view. Let's see. Something around 15 weeks. Rather prefer to get a view from this direction, from outer corner. It again corresponds to 14 weeks gestational age. So the fetus is normal, the pregnancy is normal. This is the hand of the fetus. This is the upper arm, the lower arm, the hand of the fetus. Now there is an impression to me that this baby has been compressed by some, is pushed down, has been pushed downwards. Okay, let's take the bike pressure. Let's take the cardiac activity. Here we are. The cardiac activity is 147 to 150 beats per minute with regular waveform. You see that normally in ultrasound, placenta is spondo and spondo anterior wall. And here if you see that there is a hypopoeic area, and this is the placenta substance from here to here, and from here to here, from here to here. There is a placenta substance. Now this is the placenta substance, anterior to it, in the myometrium, you can see that there is a hypopoeic area. This one, this area, it does not change its shape when I change the direction of the probe. It measures approximately 26 by 21 millimeters. Now I am rotating the probe. So this is a fibroid relating to the anterior wall of the uterus. And I am going towards the frontal region now to get a view of all of the myometrium so that not to miss if there is any other fibroid. This is another fibroid. This is another fibroid in the region of the myometrium. Region, and this one is in the anterior segment. This, so there are two fibroids seen with this 14 weeks pregnancy. One at the anterior wall and the other near the fungal region. This is the fibroid. This is the fibroid. So, two supervisor seen in this case of however, this is the cervix and this is the internal os. It is closed. Amniotic fluid, the anterior myometrium, follow the anterior myometrium, and here you come across the fibroid and anterior to the placenta. And now move upwards, go further upwards, and at the fundal region, you come across another fibroid. This one. Now, this fibroid is rather pedunculated one from the, this is the anterior myometrium. So from the fundal region we see another fibroid measuring 4.4 into 4.5 centimeters. And then when I move the probe posteriorly to see if there is any posterior wall fibroid, I don't see any. Yes, there is one more fibroid. See. And this fibroid is with the posterior wall. This is the posterior myometrium. So this is another fibroid. All hypopoietic. Now this is the cervix. It does not relate to the cervix, rather it relates to the posterior wall of the myometrium. It's posterior end, and this is the myometrium, anterior myometrium. This is the urinary fibroid. So there are multiple fibroids seen in this 14-week pregnancy of primigravida.